Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and today you're going to learn how to reassign the modifier keyboard keys. If you haven't already seen my changing keyboard layout video, Ace, I'd advise you to watch it. The card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. If you've seen my changing keyboard layout video, you'll know that we were unable to change the modifier keys using Microsoft's own keyboard layout creator. But hang on a second here, Ace. What is a modifier key? According to Wikipedia, a modifier key is a special key or combination on a computer keyboard that temporarily modifies the normal action of another key when pressed together. The most common are Shift, Control, Alt, Option, if you're on a Mac, Alt Gear, Meta Key, I must admit I've never even heard of that one, Ace, Win Key, Command, and FN for Function. All keys that I'm sure you're familiar with, Ace, well, except maybe for the Meta Key one. On the changing keyboard layout video, the majority of the comments that I've received have been requests to change these keys. I'd like to thank a commenter for suggesting the program that I'm going to show you today, Ace. Unfortunately, they haven't responded to my messages and shall remain anonymous. The program is called SharpKeys and a link to download it is in the description, though a quick Google search should get you there rightly, Ace. One thing I really like about this site is that it tells you what the program does and more importantly tells you what it doesn't do. This may seem strange, Ace, but knowing this can dispel any misunderstood assumptions that we have about the software. First, what does it do? It can map an entire key to any other key. For example, you could remap caps lock to the shift key. It can also remap more than one key to a single key. For example, you could remap every key on your keyboard to the letter Q. I would strongly advise against this, Ace, but if you have a real love for the letter Q, be my guest. Okay, great, but what does it not do? It will not allow you to swap two keys with each other. For example, you can't have Q and Z swap places because the remapping code would get confused. This to me is the most important thing that it doesn't do, Ace, and it could put you off using this software. This software can't map multiple key presses to one key. For example, it will not support an attempt to remap Ctrl+C to the F5 key. It can't map mouse clicks to any other key. It can't support hardware keys that never make it to Windows. For example, Logitech's volume buttons and most FN keys. It also can't support multiple mappings for different users. The Windows key being tweaked is for an entire machine. So if you're sharing a computer with your granny, it might seem a bit unfair to completely reassign or shift keys on her. On the other hand, if you yourself are a granny, this could be a great prank to play on your grandkids. Your needs may vary, Ace. And finally, it can't protect you from yourself. If you disable your delete key and can't log in because Ctrl+Alt+Delete doesn't work now, you'll have to reformat. This final point is another crucial one, Ace. Be careful with your reassignments. Right, now all the warnings are out of the way, let's check out this program. Download and install, Ace. Click Next in the following dialog. Select where you want to save it. Just click Next. Click Next and let it install, Ace. Click Yes in the UAC whenever it pops up. Once it's finished installing, click Close. We're now ready to use it, Ace. Okay, now it's installed. Double click on the desktop icon and click Yes in the UAC dialog if it pops up. To add a key assignment, simply click Add, Ace. From here, we need to select a key to map from and a key to map to. Now, if you're able to identify the key you want by simply reading it, Ace, good for you. You're a far more talented person than I am. But if, like me, you struggle with this type of key identification, you can simply click Type Key and press whatever key you're looking for. Here, I'm going to reassign my right Windows key to my right Shift key. So if I press my right Windows key, it'll pop up with the correct right Windows behavior. Simply click OK for that one, Ace, and then click the type key for the to key, and click whichever key you want now, which will be, for me, the right shift key. Click OK, and once you're happy with your mappings, click OK. Feel free to add more mappings here if you need to, Ace. When you're finished, click Write to Registry, click OK on the dialog box that shows up, and restart your computer, Ace. After the restart, your key should be reassigned. So if I click on the Search Windows field and hold the right Windows key down and press A, you'll see that it capitalizes it. Standard Shift key behavior, Ace. Super, but what if I don't like that anymore, Ace? How do I change it back? Well, to do that, reopen SharpKeys, click the key mapping you no longer want and click delete. Then it's the same as before, is click write the registry, click OK on the dialog box that shows up, and then restart your computer. If all goes well after the restart, your key should have the same default functionality. This is a great way to reassign your modifier keys, is. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, is. I hope this has helped. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any useful programs you use. Once again, I'd like to thank the anonymous commenter for suggesting this software to me. This video is inspired by them. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.